I'm Bill from Murderers in Ohio on YouTube, and I want to take a moment to talk to you about the Jayland Walker shooting.
So we got a killer on a run in Ohio.
I'm going to start this off by saying that I don't have anything against any law enforcement. I know it's a rough job that they have to do. When I first heard about this shooting, I heard a man got shot by law enforcement 60 times. And I'm like, wow, what can a man do to deserve to be shot 60 times? Did this guy have a AR, AK? I mean, what kind of firepower did this guy have to be shot by police 50 times, or 60 times, sorry? And to come to find out that they shot an unarmed man. They said that Jayland shot a firearm from his car, and they said they found the firearm in the car. My thing is why did they shoot him 60 times? I watched the body cam videos of this, and it's unbelievable. I want to show you this one little scene out of there. This one officer fires his firearm and has to drop his magazine, which means he fired every round out of that magazine and he has to drop it and reload. To me, that's an excessive force. I don't see how you can say that that's justifiable. That's one man. You have eight officers more arriving on the scene. Why do you have to pull off 60 rounds? Then there's another body cam video of another officer. There's already two officers shooting the young man who is laying on the ground. This one officer comes up and just starts unloading. He don't just take one shot. He fires repeatedly at a lifeless Jayland Walker on the ground. What's the point of that? That's abuse of power. I don't see how the Akron Police Department is going to be able to say that this is justifiable homicide. I don't see how they can say that this is justifiable use of force. Any kind of force. They had eight officers who could have ran him down. Jayland Walker would have eventually got tired of running. They would have caught up with him. There was no use of shooting one man 60 times. That poor young man must have felt like he was in a war. And all this has led to riots in Akron. And I can kind of see why. Now people are going to be afraid to get pulled over by the police. Jayland Walker didn't have a criminal history. He was getting pulled over for a traffic violation and he didn't stop. My only question about that is, why was Jayland wearing a ski mask? Some questions still need to be answered about all this. So I want to end this by saying, hopefully they find some kind of peace in Akron, Ohio.
We got the devil on the run.